We recently unboxed and assembled the Spider Farmer G12 indoor hydroponic system, and if you missed that video, I will leave a link to it in the description down below. As I mentioned in that video, the next step that I wanted to take was to test out its PAR levels and power draw, and that is what we are going to be going through in this video. I did things a little differently with the measurements, as we are not inside of a tent, I just decided to take the readings at each of the growing sites on the unit itself. The first batch of measurements that I took are with the light set at its closest point to the plants, which is 8.5 inches above the lid. I am going to be alternating between the measurements in its veg mode and its flower mode, and the difference between the veg and flower settings is that in veg it turns on the bright blue LEDs that are on the light board, and you will be able to see the differences in the measurements. It isn't a huge amount of extra light, but it is noticeable. Later on in the video, we will also look at the light levels with the light board at its furthest extension, but only in the veg mode, as I don't think a lot of folks are going to be using it set up like that anyways. We are starting out the measurements at a power level of 1, and we'll be working up to level 6, and not surprisingly, the light gets stronger as you work your way up the levels. These light levels are really only going to be applicable when your seedlings are starting out, and for the most part the plants will be closer with stronger light as they grow up towards it. When it comes to planting seedlings in this unit, I will likely be starting it out at a level 5. This is going to give me plenty of light across all of the spaces, and it only pulls about 30 watts from the wall at this setting, which is pretty great. I feel like level 6 may be a little too intense in the center for a lot of different seedlings, but if what you are growing will accept those light levels, then you can totally start them there as well. To be honest, I am surprised at just how much light this unit is actually putting out for how little power it is drawing, and I can see why so many of you commented that you love using these little units, and a lot of folks seem to be using them for cloning, which makes a lot of sense. With our first round of seeds in here, we are probably going to be going with a lot of flowers actually, as we want to get more of them going and planted around the property. So the light levels that we have been looking at for the last couple of minutes have been alternating between the veg and flower light levels, and as you can see, it is dropping off a bit with the bright blue LEDs turned off, but at most levels, it is also drawing slightly less power, which does make sense. Now though, we are going to be looking at the PAR levels when the light is raised to its maximum extension, which is 15 inches. As I mentioned earlier, I don't think that a lot of folks will use the unit set up like this, as it is not what the movable light is really for anyways. The reason that you can raise the light at all is so that as the seedlings sprout and grow, you can move the light up and still get those great PAR readings at level 5 and 6 without letting the plant grow completely up into the light and possibly get burnt. The closer the plants get to the light, the more intense it is going to get, and especially with small plants, you run the risk of burning the leaves with all of that light. After looking at all of these light level readings that I have done, you have probably noticed that there is quite a bit of drop off as you get to the corners and edges, and that is because there are no reflective sides on this unit, unlike you would have in a grow tent. It is pretty amazing how much those reflective sides help when it comes to spreading out the light levels in a grow tent, and I am definitely missing that in this unit. What I may actually do in the future is make a shroud out of cardboard with tinfoil on the front faces that wraps around the sides and the back of the unit, which would help immensely with not wasting any light. If you would be interested in seeing what the PAR levels would look like with that contraption on there, let me know in the comments down below, and if there is enough interest, I will get that video put together and posted. I wasn't sure what to expect when I started on all of these measurements, as the unit is really small, and with as little power as it draws, I was not expecting much in the way of light. I have been pleasantly surprised though at every level I have measured, and it has made me really excited to get some seedlings started with this unit and see what they do. I am going to be setting up one of my GoPro cameras on this unit so that we can do a constant time lapse here like I used to do with all of our cannabis grows. I will probably only update every 2 to 4 weeks though, but that is going to depend on how quickly the plants actually grow and how much there is to see that would actually make for an interesting video. A big thank you to Spider Farmer for sending over the G12 indoor hydroponic grow system, and if you want to check out this unit or any of their other gear for yourself, make sure to click on the links to their website in the video description down below and use the discount code GEEKS at checkout to get 8% off your entire order.